Began in our Las Vegas living room in 2005, the first shop ever dedicated to roller derby, and has since grown into this 2,000 square foot mecca in San Diego, where we stock everything for our sport. Need help? With a combined on-track experience of over 24 years and still playing, we test everything we sell, and we're happy to share that experience and knowledge with you. So contact us, sincityskates.com.
Good afternoon from Milwaukee, Danny Mack with Desecration. Desi, a big matchup coming up. We've already seen some great derby with Atlanta advancing. They will play Texas tomorrow at 10 a.m. What a way to kick it off with that international flavor here at WFTDA Championships. The bout coming up, fantastic. Angel City versus Rocky Mountain, two teams that have a lot to prove.
They absolutely do. Rocky Mountain has been the winner of the past four matchups. They've matched up four times, twice in 2012. All games going in Rocky Mountain's favor. But don't count out Angel City. They are excited to be here. This is their first turn to the WFTDA Championship Tournament, and you're going to hear a whole lot of fun out of them. If you're wondering what you hear out of them, you're going to hear them singing a little bit. We were blessed with that just a few minutes ago. Their team song is Sexual Chocolate. And you will also hear them saying Pop Pop, which means the power of positivity as well as power of the Pegasus. So watch out for Angel City. But not to be counted out at all is the one who's been victorious the last four times out, Rocky Mountain Roller Girls. They are going to be missing one of their very key players, and that is Sweet Mary Payne.
And if you look on the helmet from Rocky Mountain, you will see Dad M80. That's a tribute to Sweet Mary Payne's father, who passed away, unfortunately, this season. Bout's about to come up. We're going to take it to the booth with John Maddening and Brad Example.
It's true. We are. We're here.
Welcome, fantastic, folks, to WFTDA.TV coverage of championships. I am Brad Example. This is John Maddening.
Also true.
And let's start off by introducing our skaters for the Rocky Mountain Roller Girls. Number 122, Castrator. Number 125, Rocks Your Socks Off. Number 1896, Tootsie Roller. Number 30, Rad Die. Number 31, Fiona Grapple. Number 37, Bob Loblaw. Number 378, Toxic Tonic. Number 422, Gagan. Number 719 is Alpha Q Up. Number 7423, Triple Shot Misto. Number 8, Winona Fighter. Number 86, Assault and Peppa. Number 9, Yuba Alice. And number 99, May Q Pay.
And on the side of the Angel City Derby Girls, we have Duchess Van Dam. I'm a Bulbaya, Mika Spedia, Chica Go Lightning, Jane Wilkins, Soledad, Chris Robbins, Lacey Knight, Chrissy Crash, Rachel Rotten, Chinese Checker, Ghetto Fabulez, Satan's Little Helper, and Tyra Shanks.
So it looks like taking the first star for Angel City is number 316, Chris Dobbins, lining up against one of the go-to jammers for Rocky Mountain, number 122, Castrator.
Now, as Danny Mack was saying just earlier, this is a 4-0 right now. Rocky Mountain with the lead. Rocky Mountain has taken all four of those games. Rocky Mountain has also been to champs four times now, and they, of course, were the WFTDA champions in 2010. This is Angel City's first appearance in championships, and they've kind of been around for a very long time. People have known about them. A lot of people have known about them from their workout video, more from their play. But it's fantastic that they have made it here now, and they're making their first champs appearance against a tough, tough team from Rocky Mountain.
The Hollywood Scarlets have seen a lot of success earlier in the season. We'll see if they can translate that into success here at the Big Dance at the WFTDA Championships. We're down and we're away, so both jammers trying to get through that pack.
Chris Robbins at the back of the pack, still trying to get through as Castrator for Rocky Mountain has taken it. The first lead jam goes to Rocky Mountain and is already nearing the back of the pack. Chris Dobbins still trying to make her way through. Nice little jump through, halfway through for Castrator, coming around the outside and makes it through, and she's going to pick up the full 5 points after calling it off.
First blood to Rocky Mountain. They are a story team, one of the founders of the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. They were, as we already mentioned, champions in 2010, looking to get back to that status. Number 378, Toxic Tonic, taking their next star. And number 16, Chicago Lightning, is going to be jamming for Thus Hollywood Scarlets.
Yeah, with that long blonde ponytail, often difficult to see that number on the back, but that lightning bolt makes it very easy to pick up on the track. Both jammers, one to the outside, one to the inside, and retreating, both knocked out. Number 3. Toxic Tonic actually making her way through now on the outside. Coming around through, trying to one more blocker to beat. Getting caught up, but makes it. Once again, lead jam status goes to Rocky Mountain.
So two jams, two lead calls in a row for the 5280 Fight Club, but Chicago Lightning has broken out of the pack.
Kind of slowly coming around, taking a look at where she's going to make the attack, and does. No call off from Rocky Mountain, who now retreats. First penalty of the game.
It's number 101, Ima Blobaya, taking a seat for Angel City.
And a bit of a trip up there, but she gets right back up on her skates as Toxic Tonic trying to make it through a few more skaters. Gets a total of 4 points, but Angel City is also on board with 4 as well. So the score, 9-4.
And that takes us to the 28-minute mark in our first period. So in only the third jam, RMRG gives the star on the Antic Skate Boots jammer line to number 719, Alpha Q Up, and number 1337, Mickey Speedia for Angel City.
And you just saw those fantastic jammer helm covers there that echo the new uniforms that Rocky Mountain has graced us with this year. Once again, right up at the front of the pack, and Rocky Mountain making their own lead jammer goes to Alpha Q Up. Mika Speedia has finally made her way through as well. Alpha Q Up coming on through the pack, a very light pack running through. And calls it off after picking up a total of 3 to add to their score, making it 12-4 in favor of Rocky Mountain. 27:07 to go.
So Alpha was deflected into the outfield there, where she decided, nope, that's all we're going to do. And you see on the replay there, sponsored by Notorious R.E.D., exactly that scene. Alpha tapping her hips to bring an end to it. Castrator back to the line for Rocky Mountain. It looks like number 617, Ghetto Fabulez, is taking the star for Angel City.
And we are off. Both once again splitting around. Around to the outside there for Angel City. Coming up, last few blockers to beat, but get pushed out to the outside again. And once again, it seems like every single jam this is happening right now. Rocky Mountain lead jammer status, but right behind her this time, Ghetto Fabulous for the Angel City Derby Girls.
A little extra pressure from Angel City on Castrator this time. She calls it as she hits the pack. No points for Angel City. Ooh, it looks like a skating out of bounds penalty is being called on Castrator. So she'll start the next jam in the box, and we have our first power jam of the game.
And also our first coach coming out there to disagree with that call.
That's Dave Wood from the Rocky Mountain Roller Girls. Thanks to our partner, Rydell, the official skate of the WFTDA with unmatched quality and unmatched performance. It's Chris Dobbins going to take the solo star.
So in this power jam, Chris Dobbins trying to get past those two final blockers who have to let her go. Almost. I spoke too soon there. A little bridging happening, and she finally gets through, and this is the first lead jam for Angel City. Very happy to see that. I'm sure they are. 10 points behind. They want to make up this deficit while they have this power jam situation going on.
Also, a 4-3 pack advantage for Angel City, and that's going to let her through for the Grand Slam pass. Chris Dobbins taking Angel City's score to 9 points.
One more pass coming through there. It split it up a bit. 3 blockers to beat. Now 2. Bridging. Just bashing her way through those blockers, trying to hit that wall, take down brick after brick. Finally pushing through, and finally does make it through. Chris Dobbins for another 5 points. And already getting ready for her next pass. It is a tie game. Chris Dobbins comes up to that wall, pushing her way through. Gets tapped around to the inside there. Has to re-enter a little bit back through.
Power jam is over with Castrator back on the track.
And 5 points on that pass for Angel City, bringing them up to 19 in their first lead of the game. 24:30 to go.
15-point jam there for Angel City Lining up now on the Antic Skate Boots Jammer line, we've got Chicago Lightning and Toxic Tonic for Rocky Mountain.
Pivot line getting some love here as the Jammers are alone back there on the Notorious RDD start line.
So far, the Rocky Mountain skaters have stuck to a three-jammer rotation. We've seen four jammers out there for Angel City so far. Battling it out, both jammers of a strong front wall for Rocky Mountain. But now only one to beat, and the second lead call in a row going to Chicago Lightning.
Once more, and already halfway around the track as Angel City pushes out Rocky Mountain, having to force a restart all the way to the back of that pack there. Chicago Lightning finally does call it off. One additional point on that pass. Citing discretion is the better part of valor there.
Taking the score to 20-14 in favor of Angel City with about 23 minutes to go. Now on the start line, Mickey Spedio, number 1337 once again for Angel City. And number 125, Rocks Your Socks Off, taking the star for the first time for Rocky Mountain.
One blocker in the box right now for Rocky Mountain. That is Bob Loblaw, number 37. So a little bit of a pack advantage for Angel City as we begin this next jam. Now back and forth, kind of sine-waving it through that pack. Getting caught up there with the last two, but it becomes a rugby scrum right again as the back of the pack rejoins the front of the pack.
Really strong four wall by Angel City in the back of that pack.
Jammer down there, Rocks Your Socks Off, goes down on two knees for the Rockstar drop, but Mick Espedia is your lead jammer for Angel City.
Ooh, and a power jam as Rocks Your Socks Off cuts the track.
Exactly what Angel City needs right now. They had a tough go of it for those first few jams, but all of a sudden they have kind of turned on the juice here. And with another power jam, this is going to really help them out. Another 5 points for Angel City.
Pack is thinned out to three skaters for each team.
Seems like it's just taking a little easy there. Mickey Spedia kind of waving away, kind of cutting on through, and eventually making the attack. All of a sudden, full power bashes on through. 5 points for Angel City.
Angel City is employing the passive offense, trusting to their jammer to negotiate the three wall of Rocky Mountain blockers.
Hall of Heroes and a cross check begins. One more time through. Oh, it's pushed out there. Nice, nice little move there.
Gagan,
Bob Loblaw?
Yeah, Bob Loblaw, Gagan, and Salt and Pepper, the three blockers on the track right now for Rocky Mountain.
Exactly why you want Bob Loblaw on the track and not in that box. Just always, always able to just push him out. Call off there after picking up 5 points. She had passed all five skaters before getting recycled back through there. So that's 35-14 with 21-25 to go in the first half.
It has been four jams since Rocky Mountain has scored. Landing now for the first time on the Antic Skate Boots Jammer line. Number 666, Satan's Little Helper for Angel City. Number 125, Rocks Your Socks Off, still retaining the star for Rocky Mountain. 21 minutes to go in our first period, thanks to our partner, Sure Grip.
Satan's Little Helper not getting any help from her teammates back there at the back of the pack as she is still bashing her way through. 125, Rocks Your Socks Off has returned from the penalty box. As Satan's Little Helper has made it through, and another lead jam goes to Angel City. Rocks Your Socks Off now having to let through and is now in scoring position.
That ties the lead tally at four apiece.
Satan's Little Helper one more time through and calls it off after picking up 4 points, but 0 points. For Rocky Mountain.
Rocks Your Socks Off wants points, but she's not getting them from the official, and our score stands at 39-14 with 20 to go. Thanks to Bont Skate Boots. Lighter, stronger, faster. Check out our Infinity Plates.
You see on the Notorious RED replay there, that final call off. Chris Dobbins on the line for Angel City up against Alpha Q up for Rocky Mountain. Chris Dobbins getting up to the front of the pack pretty easily, but the hen having trouble up at the front with that big Rocky Mountain wall. Alpha Q up at the back of the pack, still the great rear wall there by Angel City. Everybody's trying to figure out their way through, trying to either bash through or getting around the outside, and eventually Alpha Q up comes all the way from the back It's bounced around there quite heavily, but Buzz get a lead at Jammer and is already ready to start scoring. Nice little bash out there by Chris Dobbins, pushing her out and gets pushed out herself. And a cut call on Alpha Q-Up, cutting the track penalty. Certainly not what Rocky Mountain needs right now. Angel City with this 25-point lead, and that's just going to be added to an additional pass now. No lead Jammer for Angel City, so this could go for up to that full remaining time, which is 55 seconds on the jam clock.
Rocky Mountain was trying to open an outside track for Alpha, but resulted in the penalty. That is now the first scoring pass for Chris Dobbins. Third time she's taken the star for Angel City.
Angel City just slowing down to a crawl, wanting to spread that out. And eventually they do have to let her through for 5 points. But it did take 30 seconds to get those 5 points, so it worked, slowing her down enough. This time doesn't even look like she's even ready for an attack, but then all of a sudden that rear wall kind of moves forward a little bit to stay in. Have to let her through. And that's going to be an initial 5 points, adding to that Angel City total. Just as a jailbreak happens, Rocky Mountain back up to full strength, but not before another penalty is called for Rocky Mountain. That is
number 422, Gagan, heading out there, and in fact assigned a second minute for insubordination because she did not take the quickest path to the outside of the track. So she'll be sitting there for 2 minutes. Score 50 now for Angel City. Looks like Rocky Mountain did manage to grab a few points. It's 18 that Alpha grabbed before she was penalized, and we do have both jammers on the track now. 122, Castrator squaring off against number 16, Chico Go Lightning, with 17 and a half.
The whistle has blown. Both folks kind of trying to figure their way out here, wanting to make a jailbreak eventually. Busting on through Chico Go Lightning, almost makes it, and just gets caught in a bit of a sandwich there up front. Oh, but a nice move from the back there. All of a sudden, Castrator comes around the outside and cuts through in and becomes lead jammer for Rocky Mountain.
Number 3, Soledad, heading to the penalty box for Angel City's pack.
Angel City still has not made their initial pass. Chica Go Lightning gets pushed out there, kind of decides where she wants to re-enter as Castrator, having her way with those Angel City blockers, doing a great job of holding her back there, and eventually do let her through just as Chica Go Lightning has made her initial pass. So 5 points were scored by Rocky Mountain before Angel City was able to get through their initial pass. And now here we go again for another pass. It's Castrator cuts on through and calls it off as she gets knocked to the outside of the pack, but not before. Oh, 0 points there scored at the end by number 16, Chica Go Lightning.
Castrator was really trying to get that jam called off as she got into the pack and did succeed. Thank you to Print Go Graphics for all your printing needs. Hit up printgographics.com. That takes us to the 16-minute mark of our first period. 50 points to 23 in favor of Angel City. Lining up on the jammer line, Alpha and Mickey Spedia.
Mickey Spedia attacked right at the beginning, trying to get through those blockers on the inside, but gets pushed back to the back of the pack and now trying to get knocked around a bit. And all of a sudden, bam, right through. Alpha Q-Up is your lead jammer for Rocky Mountain. And just Rocky Mountain now bleeding blockers as number 30, Raddai, and number 8, Winona Fighter, both go to the box.
So we're getting points now. None for Angel City, 2 for Rocky Mountain on the jam. So there was a period of time there where Angel City really had figured it out and was getting successive lead calls, but are Rocky Mountain finding their skate legs again, and they've had the last 3 lead calls in a row.
Castrator jamming for Rocky Mountain, and she's going up against Ghetto Fabulez for the Angel City Derby Girls. 2 blockers in the box for Rocky Mountain, but Angel City is at full strength, so we're going to see how that helps them out a bit. Already back to the back of the pack, Castrator, as lead jammer status is called for Ghetto Fabulez.
Period clock ticking down past the halfway mark. 14 and a half right now with a minute 40 to go in the jam.
Ghetto Fabulez being held back by the back 2 blockers there for Rocky Mountain. She's pushing, 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 trying to make her way through, and eventually finds a hole and cuts through the inside for five big roller derby points. That is a grand slam for Angel City. And now Castrator has made it her way through the pack and can begin scoring points. And a hop skip through. And an additional 4 points for Angel City. Angel City really kind of dominating after those first few jams where they were just held down there by Rocky Mountain. I don't think that Rocky Mountain was really expecting Angel City to come out this strong.
Well, here we got a replay from sponsored by Notorious R.E.D. You see the end of that jam and the call-off earning 9 points total for Angel City on the jam. A return of Satan's Little Helper, number 66, to the Antic Skate Boots jammer line. Scoring off against number 378, Toxic Tonic.
Still two blockers for Rocky Mountain in the box, so a very, very light pack for them. Satan's Little Helper, lead jammer between turns one and two there. Big smile on her face, and which turns into a gritted teeth as she decides that she's going to make this very, very angry attack here right to the back of the pack. Making her move. A nice little wedge there, not pushing her out a little bit, but she managed to stay in. Satan's Little Helper calling it off. 2 points scored by Rocky Mountain, but four for Angel City. That's going to bring Angel City up to 63. Rocky Mountain at 27 with 13 minutes to go.
Thank you to Fast Girl Skates. It's about you. Fast Girl Skates, serving skaters of all shapes and sizes since 2007. FastGirlSkates.com. Alpha taking the star for Rocky Mountain. And it looks like Mickey Spedia.
It is. All right. Right behind Mickey Spedia. And just Mickey Spedia actually turned around. It grabbed to the outside real quick there. And up at the front of the pack, it becomes lead jammer Mickey Spedia.
Has three in a row.
Alpha Q up kind of biding her time there, kind of deciding when she was going to make that attack, and eventually gets the last blocker gets knocked out of the way for her, so it becomes a little bit easier for her. Still a half track behind the rest of the pack as Mikispedia is making her scoring pass here.
Now it's Angel City losing blockers on the track as a three wall of Rocky Mountain skaters keeps the pace fast. They want to deny any scoring points to Mickey Spedia.
Yeah, very, very fast pack here. Nice to see this pack moving here. Mickey Spedia decides to call that off. 0 points for her, but 3 points for Rocky Mountain.
Still a 33-point lead for Angel City as we go past the 12-minute mark. It'll be about 11 and a half at the start of this next jam, where you'll see the jammers Castrator and Chris Dobbins. So if you like what you're hearing us say, you can talk to directly to thousands of Derby fans by advertising on WFTDA.tv.
And quick through, a lead jammer status goes to Castrator for Rocky Mountain, exactly what they need right now. But another two Rocky Mountain players tending to the box. That's number 30, Rad Die, and number 99, Make You Pay. And right away, Gagan right behind her is going to have to check in, say, nope, there's no room at the inn, and go right back in. Rocky Mountain getting into major penalty trouble here. 4 points already for Castrator now, but it's going to be very, very difficult on these next few passes for her.
Castrator's going to try and pass up Dobbins. And in fact, the Angel City coach indicates that Dobbins should keep skating. So far, she's managed to stay out in front of Castrator.
But again, this is very, very fast pack speeds here.
This jam is going a long time.
Yeah, the pack is actually pacing those jammers. And eventually, she makes her move. Chris Dobbins does. Gets 4 points for Angel City.
Castrator is in the pack for points of her own, but not all the way through the pack yet.
Getting tapped around there. Eventually does make it through, but no, gets called back behind those two final blockers. Gets past Soledad. And that is going to be a full 4 points pass for Castrator. Going to take a seat. So Angel City, after that jam, still leads 67 to 38, just under 10 minutes remaining in this game. This half.
Teed up on the Antic Skate Boots jammer line, we've got number 378, Toxic Tonic, for the 5280 Fight Club. Her opponent, number 16, Chica Go Lightning.
And we have a timeout called by Rocky Mountain.
So, that gives us time to thank another of our sponsors. So thanks to Roller Derby Elite Series Skates. They're involved in roller derby since 1936. You can't beat that heritage right there. RollerDerby.com. So, man, it's been back and forth in terms of lead jammer calls so far, but the points after the fifth jam, that's when Angel City got up on top of the scoreboard, and they've stayed there ever since. Still, now it's a, let me count on my fingers, 29-point advantage for Angel City. Now, as longtime Derby folks know, that can be made up in a single jam, but not the way these jams have been going. Angel City has been holding a really strong four wall at the back of the pack and moving it up to the front of the pack when necessary. I'm really impressed by Angel City's defense.
Yeah, what I liked was when we were looking at Angel City there on the side of the track there during that timeout. No smiles. They're all serious. They have a nice little advantage right now, but they know that anything can change at any time. And they were still serious in this game. They've got to be proud of how they're doing right now. But there's still plenty of time to play. Chicago Lightning making her move, trying to get on through. As Toxic Tonic makes her way to the front of the pack. One more Angel City blocker to beat. And eventually does. Lead jammer status goes to Rocky Mountain, but followed very, very closely by Chicago Lightning. So now it becomes a race between her and Toxic Tonic, trying to get to the back of that pack. Toxic Tonic gets past one skater, calls off the jam. 0 points and one for Rocky Mountain. Zero for Angel City, one for Rocky Mountain.
Looks like the Angel City bench calling for a skating out of bounds penalty. It doesn't look like they're getting it. So 39-67 with less than 9 minutes to go.
Yeah, that skating out of bounds penalty has given a lot of teams a lot of trouble this tournament season. And I think a lot of people are just keeping an eye on it and watching their feet a lot more, especially at the end of a jam. Mick Espedia on the line here for Angel City. Goes down a little bit, but gets right through and does not become lead jammer. Right at the back of the pack, Alpha Q-Up gets knocked out to the inside and has to make another move. Has to try to get through. Gets right behind that big wall of Angel City right at the back of the pack. Mick Espedia up at the front still. Has two remaining to beat. Does. Gets on through for all 5 points. That's a grand slam for Angel City. And another penalty for Rocky Mountain as Alpha Q Up takes a seat.
That's May Q Pei who's taking a seat for...
Pardon me?
Rocky Mountain, number 99. And, yeah, we've really seen... As I was saying, the strong defense this year under the 2013 rule set without minor penalties, about the only way for the first jammer through to not get lead is that no pass, no penalty. That's what we saw here. Lead did go to Alpha as soon as she got through, and she called it off. No further points scored.
Yeah, Mick Espedia was able to get through on that last pass to pick up an additional 5 points. So that brings Angel City up to 77. Rocky Mountain is at 39 with just over 7 minutes to go in the first half.
Castrator back to the line for Rocky Mountain. Her opponent, number 617, Ghetto Fabulez.
Ghetto Fabulez kind of stepping on through back and forth a little bit. Nice little bit of swagger cutting on through. Still with two to beat, and does Ghetto Fabulez, your lead jammer for Angel City, and just checking her helmet cover just to be safe. And I've seen too many skaters not have that happen to them.
Fiona Grapple penalized now for the Rocky Mountain pack.
So two blockers now in the box for Rocky Mountain, Fiona Grapple and May Q Pei. So Angel City adds just a few more, 81-39 in favor of Angel City.
That's coming down to the six-minute mark in our first period. We want to thank another WFTDA partner, the Health Insurance Marketplace. They are here in the venue helping out folks. So if Angel City continues on this trajectory, they will notch their very first victory against Rocky Mountain, and they'll advance out of the first round of their first championship tournament.
Not only that, but also break a lot of brackets in the Cheeseballs bearing bracket bonanza. I think this was a foregone conclusion for Rocky Mountain for a lot of people, but Angel City is really making their name known right now. And once again, lead jammer goes to Angel City. That is 316, Chris Dobbins, already halfway around the track. Pack split up, but then comes right back together to be as one.
Number 378, Toxic Tonic, out of the pack for Rocky Mountain. And as she approaches the pack, she does get 1 point to 4 for Angel City.
Some very, very fast, very nice moves there by Angel City. Just kind of bushing on through, taking advantage of every advantage they have. If they have a one blocker advantage, they're just capitalizing on it.
Angel City really going deep in their jammer rotation. They've had a lot of folks out there. Number 666, Satan's Little Helper, on the line for them now, whereas number 719, Alpha, is jamming for Rocky Mountain.
And it's working for him. Satan's Little Helper gets through for lead jammer status for Angel City. Yeah, when you have that many skaters that can jam effectively, it's a fantastic idea to kind of use them continually so the little three rotation doesn't get tired. 5 more points for Angel City, and the call-off is made. 0 for Rocky Mountain. That's going to bring Angel City up to 90 to Rocky Mountain's 40. So a 50-point deficit Rocky Mountain finds themselves here in the waning moments of the first half.
About 4 to go. Enough time for 2, 3, maybe 4 jams left in the half. Number 16, Chicago Lightning, has the star for the Hollywood Scarlets and for the 5280 Fight Club, number 122, Castrator.
Pat kind of deciding whether they want to start on the pivot line or the jam line, making their way back and forth a bit. Chicago Lightning making the first attack, pushing through around the inside, but follows, makes a hole, and ends up, Castrator ends up capitalizing on that and grabbing lead jammer status for Rocky Mountain. Hot on her skates, though, Chicago Lightning, wanting to narrow that margin here. Catching up to her very closely as Castrator is about to make her initial pass.
First lead call in a little while for Rocky Mountain.
Gets 4 points for Rocky Mountain, but 4 points added to the total for Angel City as well, bringing them up to 94, Rocky Mountain 44.
Now here we see a big advantage in the pack as there are 3 blockers out there for Rocky Mountain and only one at this instant. Make it 2 as one of the Angel City blockers finds no room in the penalty box and comes back to play.
And Castrator is taking a gamble there, which really, really paid off. Didn't call it off after that last jam. And Chicago Lightning got caught up and is still having trouble there on this pass. It's Castrator now coming up at the back of the pack, the back of the Angel City blockers here, trying to bust her way through. 4 more points scored by Angel City. 4 more points by Chicago Lightning.
The notorious RED penalty box releasing a couple of the Angel City blockers, and that will make room for at least one more of their blockers who we saw returning to the track.
Castrator with an additional 4, bringing Rocky Mountain up to 57. And just like that, they've added 9 points, where they've narrowed the lead to 9.
Castrator still pushing.
Oh, boy.
That's an out-of-play blocking call on the foremost Angel City blocker.
So she gets a penalty and 5 big points for Rocky Mountain and an all-way around the track. Eagles into a call-off. And an additional 3 points for Angel City, but 4 more points in that last pass for Rocky Mountain. So just like that, it narrowed a 50-point deficit to a 44 points. So getting it, so chipping away at the lead a bit. 101, so Angel City has crossed the century mark. 66 for Rocky Mountain, 146.
And a team timeout being called now. No, official review being called by Angel City. And so we'll find out what that is about and get back to you. Official reviews are brought to you by Notorious R.E.D. Notorious Gear Deodorant. Play dirty, smell clean.
Well, what a way to begin this tournament. I mean, first you had that nail biter between the fine folks down in Atlanta and our neighbors across the sea, the London Roller Girls, bringing it to the last jam, and it's kind of a heartbreaker for all these folks that traveled so very far. But those London skaters and London fans,
Angel
are still
City
in the front row of this one.
Challenging the score in the previous jam, the referees will discuss.
All right, you heard that. Angel City's challenging the score on that previous jam. Referees are going to talk about it and make sure all of the ones are dotted and the twos are crossed.
35-point deficit right now for the Rocky Mountain Roller Girls. They're going to send Toxic Tonic to the jammer line facing Mickey Speedia.
These skaters, not knowing how long this official review is going to last, they are they're just jockeying for position themselves, making sure that when it's over, they are going to have the position that they want.
So it looks like we've got temporarily a 3-2 pack advantage for Rocky Mountain.
As you see, a lot of there's that that London crew that made that long journey over here to the States to cheer on their team. Large number of skaters of fans that were cheering on both those teams. Loudest first game I have heard at a tournament in a long time.
I think both of that last game and this game, challenges to people who entered the Cheese Balls, Bearings, Bracket, Bonanza, still time to, well, I don't know if there's still time to enter that, actually. There is still time. If you are listening to the audio broadcast, you can get the high-quality video feed for $20 for the weekend. Go to WFTDA.tv/passes.
And we're going to throw it over to Double H here, who has a little update on what was happening there.
We are receiving word that the score is going to stand, but we will, of course, allow the crew head referee to tell us that.
Stay tuned this weekend. This is only the first round of action. Here we go.
Confirm. 3 points were awarded. No change was made.
All right. Just as you said, Double H, thank you very much. All right, and probably the last jam of this half is about to begin with Toxic Tonic on the line for Rocky Mountain up against Mickey Speedia for Angel City. Whistle's blown, and here we go. Toxic Tonic makes it through lead jammer. I'm sure that Rocky Mountain is what they want to finish this first half hard, finish this first half tough.
And a forearm penalty.
Oh, dear. So this is going to give Rocky Mountain a chance to kind of cut through, kind of come back from this.
This is actually Rocky Mountain's first power jam of the whole game.
So 5 points already. We got a minute for Rocky Mountain to score as many points as possible to narrow that margin. Five more as Soledad is going to take a seat as well, making it a little bit easier for Toxic Tonic to cut on through.
Looks like number 360, Chrissy Crash, poised to re-enter for Angel City.
So that's 15 points already scored by Rocky Mountain, and just like that, the game is changing. One more pass through, and there we go, 20 points. A 20-point jam already for Rocky Mountain.
Toxic Tonic able to keep those skates in bounds.
And Triple Shot Misto has returned from the notorious RED penalty box as another pass is made. 25 points. Wow. Just like that, everything changes and it becomes a 10-point game. From a 50-point deficit, they have come back. It is, oh,
here on the notorious RED instant replay, you'll see the end of that jam there. Toxic Tonic notices that she still has time to call off the jam.
So it's going to be a photo finish, whether we have enough time to begin that last jam here.
Toxic, or it's Alpha.
And the answer is no.
Nope. Yep. Fewer than 30 seconds left, and so neither team called timeout. That takes us down into halftime, 15 minutes of halftime. John Maddening, this is turning out to be a much closer game than I had anticipated.
Yeah. It started out very much in Rocky Mountain's favor, and then Angel City came back and, again, created that, just as I just said a few minutes ago. They had a 50-point lead at one time, and as we go into the half, only 10 points separate these two teams. There's a few folks on the side of Rocky Mountain who are having some penalty trouble. Bob Blah Blah with 4, Gagan with 4 as well. But over on Angel City, they're doing okay. Only 2 players with 3 or more. That is Jane Wilkins with 3 and Soledad with 3 trips to the box as well. Leading Rocky Mountain right now, Castrator with 46 points. Angel City, it is a bit more spread out than that. Chris Dobbins with 34, Mickey Speedy with 25, Ghetto Fabulas and Satan's Little Helper with 13 each. I'm sorry, Toxic Tonic also scoring 33 points for Rocky Mountain. It's this is going to be a kind of a nail-biter, I think, in the second half.
Toxic Tonic actually a little bit more effective for Rocky Mountain, having scored 20 points more than her opponents while on the track.
Wow. Well, thanks for joining us so far. We are going to be going into halftime, and we will see you back here in just a few short minutes. For Brad Example, I'm John Madding. Thanks for watching on WFTDA-TV. We will be back in just a few.
Dang, Mo. I've been seeing the same old boring commercials during the tournaments.
Man, I haven't seen Captain Antic and Boy Reckless forever. I wonder what they've been up to.
I really wish they would bring us something all new.
Captain Antic, I think we've been gone too long.
Boy Reckless, I think it's time for something all new.
I think it's time to get our WAD on.
This is how I do all new.
Oh, one.
This is how I do all new.
All new.
All new.
All new.
All new.
All new.
All new. All new.
This commercial is brought to you by Three Monster Roller Sports,
CrossFit Denton,
and Derby Skins.
Helmet laboratories today testing some helmets. We are testing soft foam helmets versus hard foam helmets. We have the Lifer hard foam CPSC certified on the head form now. We're going to drop it from the drop tower and we're going to measure the g-force of the impact. We're going to take this helmet up 2 meters for its drop. In order to pass this test, this helmet must reduce the energy pulse to under 300 g's. Hit 186.75 G's. That's a pass. We've got a soft foam helmet on the head form now. We're going to bring it up to the same distance we did the hard foam helmet and see what happens. As you can see, the soft foam helmet that was dropped from the same distance as the hard foam helmet registered an 827 peak G. The hard foam helmet registered a 186. 300 G's passes the CPSC certified test. This helmet fails.
Back, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for joining us here on WFTDA-TV. We're here at the U.S. Cellular Arena here in beautiful downtown Milwaukee, Wisconsin for the WFTDA Championships 2013. And if you're just joining us after that first half, you missed a heck of a heck of a first half. Rocky Mountain really kind of had looked like they had Angel City's number for the first four jams. And then all of a sudden, Angel City just came from out of nowhere and knocked it out of the park. At one point, getting up to a 50-point lead over Rocky Mountain. Then that all changed, all fell apart in those last two jams where Rocky Mountain scored 50 points themselves. So at the beginning of the second half, we have a 10-point game. Angel City with 101, Rocky Mountain with, 91.
Yes, welcome back to From Halftime, sponsored by Crazy Skates at CrazySkateCo.com. And we, as John Banding just said, in that last two jams, 51 points for Rocky Mountain to 11 for Angel City. Now, Angel City has actually never defeated any of the other teams at this tournament. They have not played all of them, but the ones that they have played have been victorious so far. And in fact, Rocky Mountain in particular has a 4-0 record against Angel City Does that change today? We'll see in the second half.
Yeah, man, we look at these this history here. They've played Denver once, lost. They played Philly once, lost. They played Rocky Mountain four times, lost, all four. Bay Area, they've lost three games. Atlanta, they've lost once. And Rat City, they've lost twice. So is this the time that they are really going to turn this around? We will see. We got 30 minutes more back on the clock, and we are about to begin again. On the jammer line, we have Mick Espedia for the Angel City Derby Girls up against Castrator for Rocky Mountain.
Mick Espedia actually starting the game or the jam in the penalty box, although she's standing up, meaning she has fewer than 10 seconds before she gets back on the track.
And Castrator already through as Mick Espedia is released and decides to go all the way to the front and make her jump through. Castrator coming up to the back of the pack right now. Oh, almost. Mick Espedia was almost trying to follow Castrator through, getting past those Rocky Mountain blockers. Got caught up a bit. So now is trying to fight her way through as Castrator gets pushed to the outside and has to recycle a bit. But eventually does pass through, gets up 5 points, bringing this down to a 5-point game.
This is still Mick Espedia's very first pass, and the pack for Rocky Mountain spreading out to hang on to her as long as they can. Triple shot Misto and Winona Fighter. The last lines of defense. Mick Espedia is out.
And Castrator now has passed through once again. This time for 4 points. And all of a sudden, just like that, it is a 1-point game.
Both teams reaching the century mark. 101 to 100 in favor of the Hollywood Scarlets. Looks like Angel City's coach looking for a track cut call.
That's right. A little bit of a disagreement going on there. Looks like the call's going to stand. Some shaking of the heads from the refs.
Number 666, Satan's Little Helper, who, by the way, has gotten lead each of the times she's been out there against number 378, Toxic Tonic for Rocky Mountain.
Yeah, four jams, four lead jams, 13 points. This time that didn't work out for her. This time Toxic Tonic takes lead jam status for the Rocky Mountain Roller Girls. But Satan's Little Helper does get through right now as Toxic Tonic coming up at the back of the pack trying to make her way through. The only way she knows how. Gets turned around, calls it off. She scores 3 points that time, bringing Rocky Mountain back in the lead for the first time since the fifth jam of the game.
Holy cow. Thanks to Adam Wheels at AdamWheels.com, a proud partner and official wheel of the WFTDA. And we've got ourselves a game on our hands. Number 316, Chris Dobbins, jamming against number 719, Alpha Q, up for Rocky Mountain.
One blocker in the box right now for Angel City. Zero for Rocky Mountain, so Rocky Mountain has the full pack out there.
Really tough pack for both jammers here. Neither of them making a lot of progress.
Final blocker back in the pack, so we have both teams at full strength. As the pack speed totally turns up there, Chris Dobbins is pushed to the back of the outside and eventually does get through. That's going to cause Gagan to go to the box for her fifth trip. So she's really got to watch that. Oh, double hit there. She made it through, but it really, really somethinged her up there as Alpha Q up. Eventually gets through, gets down, and gets hit in the back. Not a back block, but gets hit in the back as she was going down. Very, very, the look on her face, I can only say.
That gives us our second lead change in as many jams with Angel City on top, 105 to 103, 26 and a half in our second period. Chicago Lightning out there for the Hollywood Scarlets against Castrator for the 5280 Fight Club.
Angel City at full blocking strength, Rocky Mountain with Gagan in the box right now. And a nice little rugby scrum as we push on through, and the pack splits up a little bit. Chicago Lightning gets the whip and gets lead jam status for the Angel City. Chicago Lightning already three quarters of the way back and about to begin her attack. Her scoring pass gets tossed around a bit there as Castrator making her way through. Chicago Lightning calling it off.
Rachel Rotten to the penalty box for Angel City. Four and out for Chicago Lightning, 109 to 103.
We have 25 minutes and 50 seconds to go in this game.
Toxic Tonic back to the line for Rocky Mountain. And Mickey Spedia returning. She was the first jammer this period.
Both teams with one blocker in the box, so slightly light packs. 3-on-3. And the whistle blows. Here we go. Pushing her way through. Amika Spedia is trying to make her way all the way through the front. Gets caught up a little bit. Oh, gets tangled up like a speeder bike on Endor, but they eventually gets through. Lead jam status goes to Angel City.
Angel City has shown some really impressive defense in this game. They've been holding on to Rocky Mountain's jammers, and in fact, Toxic Tonic still not out of the pack on her initial pass. Whistles blowing Soledad, number 3 for Angel City, to the penalty box.
Nick Espedia kind of pirouetting numerous 360s after she gets hit and knocked around a bit, but manages to stay on her skates. 5 points for Angel City. So I think they might have gotten a little bit scared there and eventually just kind of slowed things down and said, you know what, let's get back to the fundamentals. We were doing so good, just slowly building up that point total. And just like that, we're back 11-point lead right now. Angel City 114 to Rocky Mountain's 103.
And that, in fact, has kept Rocky Mountain at 103 for the last four jams. Rocky Mountain giving the star to Alpha to see if she can break that drought. Number 617, Ghetto Fabulous, with the star for Angel City.
Still slightly light packs as Rocks Your Socks Off is in the box for Rocky Mountain. Soledad and Rachel Rotten for Angel City. Your lead jammer is Alpha Q up, number 719 for the Rocky Mountain Roller Girls. But it's followed closely on her skates. Ghetto Fabulous trying to narrow down that distance. Alpha up at the front of the pack, trying to get her hips out in front. 0 points for Angel City, 0 points for Rocky Mountain. Score does not change. 114 to 103, 23:45 to go.
Thanks to Rydell, the official skate of the WFTDA. Unmatched quality and unmatched performance. Castrator back to the line for Rocky Mountain against Chris Dobbins. This is a repeat of the very first jam of the game.
Well, let's see if it goes as well for Rocky Mountain as it did that time. It was a 5-0 jam for Rocky Mountain to start this game up. Pushing on through.
11-point deficit for Rocky Mountain.
Chicago Lightning at the front of the pack has to get by the pivot and does. Gets past Tootsie Roller there. Lead jammer goes to Angel City, but hot on her skates. Rocky Mountain's Castrator eventually does call it off. 0 point score. Goose egg, goose egg.
Second scoreless jam in a row, which in general is fine with Angel City as they have the advantage, but this is certainly not enough of a cushion to sit on for the 23 minutes remaining in this game. It's number 666, Satan's Little Helper, with the star for the Hollywood Scarlets, and for the Fight Club, number 719, Alpha, after only one jam away.
Rocks Your Socks Off for Rocky Mountain and Soledad for Angel City, still in the box, so a 3-on-3 box situation right now. Satan's Little Helper is trying to push her way around the outside, cuts to the inside, trying to get past those final two Rocky Mountain blockers as Alpha Q up is making her way through to the front. Oh, but a track cut penalty on Alpha. She's going to take a seat as Angel City goes on another power jam. Angel City has had quite a few chances for power jams in that first half there, but has not capitalized on them the way that Rocky Mountain was able to. So we'll see if that was able to turn themselves around. Satan's Little Helper push, chest to chest, trying to get past, and eventually it has to be let through. 5 big roller derby points for Angel City.
Rocks Your Socks Off trying to hang on to the front, just could not do it. There's only so far you can bridge.
Like a lion.
A fierce attack.
Putting her arms up. Rawr. And a block out of play goes to Make You Pay. Going to take a seat. 5 more points added to Angel City's lead right now, bringing them up to 124. So that's a 21-point lead over Rocky Mountain at 103. And already is making another scoring pass. Already got the ghost points and gets the full 5 there. Another grand slam for Angel City.
At the cost of one of their blockers.
I think they'll take it as a sacrifice fly, you know. All right, one more time. Here we go. Another scoring pass here by Satan's Little Helper.
Alpha's back on the track, but...
Oh, and cuts through.
Alpha's through and ready to go. I was incorrect. There was not a star pass.
But a nice move there, taking advantage of the confusion on the track. Alpha Q up was out of the box and right through.
It appears that they were treating that as an incomplete star pass because Satan's Little Helper was just trying to call it off, and that didn't work.
All right, Alpha up at the front of the pack gets through one more time for 4 points, but 5 points were scored on that last pass, that kind of aborted star pass action there. By Satan's Little Helper. So that's going to bring the total to 134 for Angel City, 107 for Rocky Mountain.
That's nevertheless Rocky Mountain's first points in seven jams. So they'll take what they can get.
All right. So as it begins again, Castrator on the line for Rocky Mountain, number 122 in the black and red, up against Micaspedia in the white and gold. But this time it's Castrator. Gets lead jammer status for Rocky Mountain Roller Girls.
That last jam did burn 2 minutes off the clock, taking us to the 20-minute mark in the second period.
Coming up on the back of the pack, Castrator out to make her move. Does. 1, 2, 3, and calls it off. Oh, but we had
two points.
2 points. Not three. Once again, Rocky Mountain's coach out here. Disagreeing with some, I believe he thought there was a penalty, just like my good buddy Kool-Aid was sitting next to me, was thinking there was a backlog penalty here.
We do have a timeout called now, and in fact, an official review, perhaps? It's certainly an official timeout, which is brought to you by Notorious R.E.D., Notorious Gear Deodorant. Play dirty, smell clean. Also thank Viva Las Vegas Skates, I can speak. VivaLesSkates.com. They are sponsoring our photo booth here.
That's always fun to see.
You can check out the photos from that on WFTDA's Facebook page, facebook.com/WFTDA.
And it looks like there is going to be a backlog penalty there called on Rachel Rotten for the Angel City Derby Girls. So she is going to start that off, this jam off, in the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box.
Jammers haven't changed. Still Alpha versus Chica Go Lightning. Chica's actually not on the track right now.
You're seeing some Angel City fans there.
Oh, on the Mickey side. Speedia.
Oh, pardon me.
Returning to the penalty box.
So that was the backlog penalty, the late call backlog penalty that Rocky's calling off. And we're going to get a little clarification in just a second. As Alpha Q up is already up and through. Low block penalty on Angel City is going to give her lead jam status right away. And that brings down Angel City to only two blockers on the track right now, with a full complement of skaters for Rocky Mountain. Exactly what they need with this deficit that they are finding themselves in right now. 25-point deficit as it stands. But now it's only 20 as a grand slam takes place.
This is the second power jam in favor of Rocky Mountain. They were really able to capitalize on that first one at the end of the first half.
And already 10 points scored by Rocky Mountain in this jam. Still 1 minute 18 seconds to go in the jam. About 20 seconds left of that jammer penalty.
Alpha approaching those blockers from Angel City very deliberately and calling it off with a few seconds remaining in the power jam. Takes the score to 122. For Rocky Mountain, 13 points on the jam altogether, 134 for the last three jams for Angel City, 18 minutes to go.
And if we could go over to Double H here for a little clarification on that backlog penalty that was called.
We need the...
Well, the backlog penalty was called, and there was some question about whether or not there was an illegal call-off, and it was not, so that was only 1 minute that the white jammer was sitting.
Toxic Tonic with the star for Rocky Mountain is able to get through and earn lead, third lead call in a row.
But back in the game, once again, is Micaspedia coming up on the back of the pack here, trying to push her way through, getting knocked around, getting pushed back to the outside and having to retreat way, way back here as Assault and Peppa tried to fool her into saying, no, it was me. But in reality, she managed to a very good eye there on Micaspedia there, keeping an eye on who knocked you out and which player you're going to gain position on. 4 points added to Rocky Mountain's total here. Micaspedia has made her way through and can begin scoring points as well. So an 8-point deficit as Rocky Mountain comes upon through, and a back block penalty.
Ooh.
Back block penalty on Toxic Tonic, who's taken a seat. So this becomes an Angel City power jam.
Also means we're going to minutes with a minute of that left.
Wow. this is not the game that people were thinking at the, in the first few jams, and then halfway through, five more points added to Angel City again. Players going back and forth, into the box, out of the box.
Big 4-2 pack advantage for Angel City.
Oh, boy. And a back block. And a back block penalty this time on Angel City as Mick Espedia is going to go to the box. That is a fantastic, I mean, it is a great, great sigh of relief for Rocky Mountain and the Rocky Mountain fans as Toxic Tonic rejoins. They thought they were down for a full minute, but, man, about 40 seconds were taken up by that. Toxic Tonic already through, trying to make her way in her initial pass here.
John Maddening, I want to see what happens to the momentum for these teams, because it looked like Rocky Mountain was finally getting a little bit of traction in a few jams. Most of the momentum this half has been for Angel City. Then it flipped back, and then it flipped again. So
3 points were scored by Rocky Mountain in that jam, 4 points for Angel City, so the differential is not going to change too much. We have Angel City's coach out talking to the refs right now, getting a little clarification.
Period clock is still ticking.
Yep.
You know, the coaches can talk in the 30 seconds that are between jams.
And with 5 seconds remaining, both coaches heading back to their benches, so we're going to be able to start this jam on time. No timeouts, no official reviews called. Castrator jamming now for Rocky Mountain. Mikispedia in the box. 2 Rocky Mountain skaters in the box. Make that 1. As Bob Loblaw has returned.
So we got a full pack out there for Rocky Mountain to a full pack for Angel City. And in fact, everybody's back on the track. We're 5-on-5 as Mikispedia is jamming again.
Mikispedia coming to the back of the pack here for Rocky Mountain. Rocky Mountain kind of converging on her, clumping up around here, making it very, very difficult for her to get through as Castrator picks up 4 points. And is already to the back of the pack and ready to start passing more and scoring more points for Rocky Mountain. Oh, another push to the outside there from Mikispedia, trying to figure it out. Decides to take the single and is through. No!
A track cut for Mikispedia. Another power jam.
Yeah.
An extension.
I think the outside pack ref and the jammer ref had different opinions on that pass there.
And after that pass, we've got a 5-point deficit, 138 to 143.
And this is about to change once again. Here we go, 5 points.
Game.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's a tie game. Wow. Making the run through, Castrator passed 1, so she gets the ghost point. Pass 2. Trying to get her hips out in front of the skater, so even if she's not able to pass them, she's still able to get the points. Doesn't matter. She gets on through. 5 points for Rocky Mountain, and they take the lead. 148-143, 13 minutes, 45 seconds to go in this game. Castrator once again making a pass. And this is very, very cool. What you see when Castrator's making these passes, she calls it off after getting an additional 5. It's very, very cool here when you see this. She's coming up and she's making a point to just turn around and thrust out those hips. And so even if she's not able to pass that skater, she does get able to get the points for him.
So
a 10-point lead now for Rocky Mountain at the beginning of this game, or the beginning of this half, 17 minutes ago, we had a 10-point lead for Angel City.
Team timeout called by Angel City. That's the first. Check out this replay here, sponsored by Notorious R.E.D., calling off that jam at the... That's going to preserve... Mikispedia has held the jammer star for the last 5 jams for Angel City. It's been that long since they've been able to field a fresh jammer.
Yeah, she has got to be feeling tired out there. So, this time they have got to make this a pure offensive jamming position. As soon as she gets back in here, they need to protect her. They need to force her way through. There's not going to be, I don't think they're going to be trying to do anything passive, anything trying to split off this pack and make her fight her way through. They really need to help her just get out of this jam. More minutes remaining here in this jam, ready to start here.
With all those penalties, Mikispedia still has only 4 penalty minutes, so she's not quite in danger of fouling out yet. 13 minutes and 23 seconds on the stopped clock. It was stopped by the Angel City timeout. Both teams have 2 timeouts remaining.
So here we go. Alpha Q up. A is jamming for Rocky Mountain and is already through, but goes down. Oh, and a low block on Soledad. That's going to be her fifth penalty minute right now. Lead jammer, ready to cut through. Cuts around that back wall. Rocky Mountain slowing it down as Mika Speedy has returned. And a star pass
to number 316, Chris Dobbins. She's got the star on her helmet. It's a successful star pass.
Who's already been in HMs and has scored 38 points for Angel City. But just really, really needed to get her out of there.
So five more for Alpha. Dobbins is out of the pack, so Alpha calls it off.
So 20-point lead right now for Rocky Mountain. 163 to 143. 12 minutes, 30 seconds remaining in this game.
That is by far the largest lead that Rocky Mountain has held so far in the game. Thanks to our WFTDA partner, Blood and Thunder Magazine, lining up on the Antic Skate Boots Jammer line. We've got Chicago Lightning, number 16 for Angel City, and we've got number 378, Toxic Tonic.
I'm a Bulabaya and Soledad are both in the box for Angel City, so it's going to be a very, very tough pack for them, for Angel City to get through. And Rocky Mountain has shown it. Toxic Tonic, lead jammer for Rocky Mountain, and Chicago Lightning already pushed all the way from the inside all the way to the back of the pack. And a grand slam takes place. Five big roller derby points added to Rocky Mountain's total, bringing them up to 168. And already three-quarters of the way around the track and are ready to begin another attack.
John Medning, I said earlier I wanted to see what this did to the momentum. It seems like it's kept it on Rocky Mountain's side, because that's four more points for them since Chicago Lightning is through and on her.
She's on her scoring pass now here. She's already passed a couple.
Toxic Tonic not calling it off. They want the points, and right now they're trusting to their pack to be able to hang on to Chicago Lightning, which they can't. There she's through for her 4 points.
Yeah, she did, though. Toxic Tonic did check with her bench to make sure that she was not supposed to call it off. They said keep on going. They got a good lead right now. They're going to take that advantage, and another additional 4 points is added to that lead. That's going to bring them up to 176 to Angel City's 147, so a 29-point lead now for Rocky Mountain.
They did get it called off before Angel City able to score any more points, and so that's 10.5 to go roughly in the game. Castrator back to the line for Rocky Mountain.
Ghetto Fabulous is going to be wearing the jammer star for Angel City. This is going to be her fifth appearance jamming tonight. As the scrum begins, Ghetto Fabulous, she's going back and forth and back and forth at the back of the pack trying to find a weak point. But Castrator is the one that eventually does get through. Lead jammer for Rocky Mountain.
Rocky Mountain really relying on that trio of Castrator, Toxic Tonic, and Alpha. And it's paying off now. They seem to have found their skate legs. They were struggling a little bit in that first period.
Yeah, it looks like Winona Fighter is going to take a seat for a low block there. And a back block on number 122, Castrator for Rocky Mountain, makes this an Angel City power jam. Jane Wilkins still in the box, but she is standing.
That could be costly for Rocky Mountain, depending on how much they're able to hang on. Clockwise blocking penalty now on Bob Loblaw, reducing both packs to 2 blockers.
Grand slam for Angel City.
Wilkins back on the track now, making it a 3-2 advantage for Angel City.
One more bust through, and she does. Adds another 5 points for Angel City. And just like that, these scores are, I mean, these are going to be some very, very high-scoring games here. Getting very close. Another grand slam probably about to happen. There's only 2 blockers out there for Rocky Mountain. And she just kind of bashes her way through. Number 74, 23, triple shot Misto. Doing an excellent job of trying to hold her back, at least slowing her down. And that can make the difference between another pass or not. But that was no pass, no penalty. So 4 points on that last pass.
It's a 15-point game, 176 to 161 at this moment. Oh. And what do we see? A forearm penalty on
number 99. Make You Pay is getting that forearm penalty. She got caught up a little bit with Winona Fighter, who was returning from the penalty box, trying to deal with Ghetto Fabulous, who has passed through one more time for an additional 5 points. That's going to bring them up to 166. So it's a 10-point game yet again. But right out of the box again, Castrator is back and has scored 4. So after that, 180 to 166, a 14-point lead for Rocky Mountain. 8 minutes, 20 seconds to go in this game.
I am not willing to predict the outcome here, John Maddening. Thanks to
Crew
Skate
there
Shop.
Was sorry, there was Ooh. That massive, massive hit there. the what? What did you see? What, I didn't do anything on the Notorious R.E.D. instant replay there. Just totally stopped the forward momentum of Angel City there. This time we have got Chris Dobbins jamming for Angel City.
And Alpha out there for Rocky Mountain.
Make You Pay still in the box for Rocky Mountain. The front of the pack, a fantastic held there, a triple threat extravaganza with that triangle being held by Rocky Mountain. But eventually, Chris Dobbins does makes it through. Dobbins is through for lead jammer.
That's the first lead call for Angel City in like eight jams. So that definitely is something they need if they're going to close the gap. They had a lot of success with the power jams that they earned from Rocky Mountain.
And takes a shirt whip off of Rachel Rotten there. Through for an additional 5 points for Angel City. That brings them up to 171, so a 9-point game. Another pass about to start happening here. Chris Dobbins back at the pack. It's pushed her out, pushed in.
Chris calls it, three of those points.
So that's up to 174, so a 6-point game now. Angel City's down by only six. 180-74, just under 7 minutes to go.
Thanks to Cruise Skate Shop and at CruiseSkateShop.com, offering quality-tested derby gear and guidance since 2007.
Make You Pay still in the box, but she is standing, so she has less than 10 seconds, fewer than 10 seconds, remaining on that penalty.
Castrator and Satan's Little Helper on the Annex Take Boots jammer line. 6.5 to go in the game.
Satan's Little Helper pushing her way to the front on the inside, but Castrator around the outside, then cuts through to the in, and is lead jammer for Rocky Mountain.
Chris Dobbins making her play. She gets out on the outside line.
Satan's little helper. He is about to make her scoring pass here. Oh, but not before the call off is made by Castrator. Picked up 2 points and was just knocked on her booty on the outside, but was able to call it off. I think as she was falling, she was calling that off.
It's a game of sixes with 6 minutes to go and 6 points between the two teams. 182 to 174. Advantage Rocky Mountain. They've held on to the lead since they took it back several jams ago.
Chicago Lightning on the jammer line for Angel City. She's going up against Triple Shot Misto for Rocky Mountain.
That's Misto's first time jamming in this game. She's been out there a lot as a blocker, but her first time with the star.
Yeah, 21 jams she has played in this game so far. But, yeah, her first time wearing that jammer helmet. Chicago Lightning gets recycled all the way to the back of the pack and having to force her way through. Triple Shot Misto gets knocked down to the outside but manages to stand. Oh, a nice move almost. Oh, gets knocked down. And we have a big pileup on I-90 there. Wow, cut through and a cut call. Track cut on Triple Shot Misto. She almost had it. Oh, boy. Chicago Lightning has lead jammer and is in a power jam. And now the passive offense begins. Gets knocked out to the inside.
Well, now
retreats.
Angel City's blockers coming up to try and help open a path through the three blockers remaining on the track for Rocky Mountain.
Chinese Checker actually holding back a couple blockers who wanted to go up there and attack, but said we were going to do a better job of holding her back. An additional 5 points.
3-point game on our hands.
One pass, two pass, three pass. She's passed all four blockers already, plus with the ghost point in the box. That's a full five. So that's an Angel City lead, 184 to 182, just over 4 minutes to go, and she's going to call it off. So she's going to start off in the power jam position. However, Triple Shot Misto is standing, so less than 10 seconds remaining, and a timeout is called by Rocky Mountain.
Thanks to Crazy Skates at CrazySkateCo.com, serious skate equipment for serious skaters, despite their name.
And you're just seeing on the Notorious R.E.D. instant replay that track cut on Triple Shot Misto, the thing that kind of changed it up for a second for Rocky Mountain. They were sitting pretty, and then all of a sudden, just a simple mistake, and everything changes. 184 to 182 in favor of Angel City. 4 minutes, 9 seconds remaining in this game.
That's Rocky Mountain calling their second time out to try to regroup. They've got one left. They might hang on to that to try and They might try to hang on to that so that they can stop the clock if there are fewer than seconds remaining. If you don't know it, fifth blocker, you're off your rocker. Thanks to fifthblockerskates.co.uk.
I think Brad Example's Scottish accent is going to cause an international incident.
I apologize.
One of these
that.
Days.
Holy mackerel.
All right.
Ghetto Fabulous, number 617. Alone with a Star on the Jammer Line, sponsored by Antic Skate Boots.
Pushed out, but makes it through before she even enters turn one. Lead jammer, Angel City. Triple Shot Misto has returned and is now having to deal with the Angel City pack at the wall at the back of the pack.
Full strength wall of Angel City. They've been rocking that back wall of the pack the whole game.
Ghetto Fabulous narrowing it down. Already passed one, and then we had two to go, but Rocky Mountain doing a great job of recycling, of getting those rest of those blackers clear through. But, and another track cut on Triple Shot Misto. Another track cut, so she's going to the box, and another power jam for Angel City as Ghetto Fabulous is the only jammer out there with 1 minute, 15 seconds remaining in this jam. Coming up, one, two, three. Just has to get by. Rocks Your Socks Off does. Five more points for Angel City.
If Angel City hangs on to this and wins it, they will face the Denver Roller Dolls tomorrow. They've only played Denver once, and Denver was victorious.
One more time through. Ghetto Fabulous inside, outside, all over this track, trying to make her way through, trying to score every single point possible. Does five more points. Another grand slam for Angel City. Man, she looks tired, but with a huge smile on her face as she's ready to make another attempt here.
Still a 4-3 pack advantage for Angel City.
And it's already broken up a bit.
Angel City bench frantically signaling to Ghetto Fabulous to call it off. She does, but not before Misto gets back on the track and Rocky Mountain calls timeout.
Wow, just like that, once again, we have back and forth. There you're going to see.
Check this replay here. Ghetto Fabulous through the pack.
And there you can see she was just...
she gets her five.
Gets her five and just, oh boy. So 204 to 182, that is a 22-point lead for Angel City with 2 minutes, 22 seconds to go in this game. One, possibly two jams to go.
Thanks to our partner Green Monster and, of course, to the official wheel of the WFTDA, Atom Wheels.
Up and Atom.
Looks like Angel City going to give the star to number 316, Chris Dobbins, who was their very first jammer of the game. This could conceivably be the last jam of the game. We've made this actually Rocky Mountain opting to make this their official review for this period. And so they will have a timeout remaining. They are going to put number 122 Castrator on the Annex Skate Boots jammer line.
Yeah, that must be a lot of adrenaline going through all of these skaters on the line. You saw Rachel Rotten there, or I'm sorry, you saw Chrissy Crash there. Just going to get into a calm place all of a sudden. They have a 22-point lead with 2 minutes to go, but that is probably going to be two jams. So we are looking, you get a view of the penalty tracking board there. Two players with six trips to the box for Rocky Mountain.
Blah, blah, blah.
Oh, I'm sorry, three players. Pardon me, I didn't see Make You Pay way at the back down
Make
there.
Make You Pay, Gagan,
in the box
and
now.
Blah, 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 all in potential trouble there. This is the 22 jam with a 22-point lead and 2:22 on the period clock.
On the Angel City side, only Soledad has five trips to the box. Jane Wilkins, Mikispedia, and Ima Lobaya each with four. Duchess Van Dam, Chrissy Crash, Chinese Checker, and Tyler Shanks with one each. Rachel Rotten with two. Yeah, so there, Angel City is sitting pretty well with penalties, especially with only two jams to go.
So this official timeout is brought to you by Notorious R.E.D., Notorious Gear Deodorant. Play dirty, smell clean.
So see, Angel City fans fanning themselves. They are so excited. This is a very, very tough game. I don't know if Angel City thought they were gonna do this well all out of the gate.
We pointed out earlier, John Maddening, that they have actually never defeated any of the other teams at this tournament. And so, in particular against Rocky Mountain, they're 0-4. This would make it 1-4, and I'm sure they would be thrilled to take that back home to Los Angeles.
Yeah, I mean, it's always a fantastic, fun time to defeat a team that you've never beaten before. You want to do it at home, but, man, doing it at Champions,
this particular leg of the bracket ended up being all Western teams because the winner of this game, both of whom are from the Western region, are going to play the Denver Roller Dolls, also from the West, in fact, from the same city as Rocky Mountain, Denver, Colorado.
A few miles apart.
So we do still have the official timeout continuing, so let me thank Derby for All at derby4all.com. Experienced Derby skaters getting you the right gear to take you to the next level. They happen to be the official skate tech for this tournament.
All right, so they're continuing to chat now with the captains, making sure, or was it with coaches, making sure everything's going okay. So let's take a look really here at Angel City, who they've got on the lines now. They have a full complement of skaters right now. Blocking, we have Soledad, Chrissy Crash, and Chinese Checker with Rachel Rodden as your pivot. Jamming in this second-to-last jam is going to be Chris Dobbins, number 316, for Rocky Mountain. Oh, and we're going to have the official update of what's happening here.
Initially, Rocky Mountain took a timeout. An official timeout was taken to discuss penalty action on the track. There's also a penalty assessed to the Angel City captain for interference in gameplay by one of their coaches.
Oh, you don't see that too often. All right, we're going to give it over to Double H, who has some a little more information on this.
Right, so from what we understand, we actually had the bench managers for Angel City approaching over the line in the penalty box.
Ah.
And, of course, now there is a penalty to be served as a result.
So Jane Wilkins is sitting in the box for Angel City right now. Rocks your socks off and make you pay for Rocky Mountain. So a slightly light pack here. But right there, Angel City is your lead jammer. Chris Dobbins, number 316, in the white and gold and red. But right through here is Castrator, about a third of a track behind, as Chris Dobbins is making her scoring pass. Cut through and calling it off. Getting a feverish call from her coach, calling off, picking up 3 points. 1 minute, 53 seconds to go in this game. Angel City 207, Rocky Mountain 182.
Angel City told me they were coming ready to play tough, strong game, and they've shown that the whole game, particularly their blocking lines at the back of the pack. They wanted to come out, and they also wanted to thank their family and friends and other league members.
Aww.
We got Satan's Little Helper squaring off against Alpha with a minute and a half on the period clock.
Satan's Little Helper all the way to the front of the pack already. Oh, and tip taps her way through. Lead jammer status goes to Angel City. Lead jammer, Satan's Little Helper. And if this is not that nail in the coffin, I don't know what is. She is going through, cutting through, and already gets the double whip through. Another 5 points added to Angel City's total, bringing them up to 212. So it is a 30-point deficit that Rocky Mountain finds themselves in right now.
Only now does Alpha escape the pack.
But an additional 4 points scored there for Angel City, bringing them up to 216. Rocky Mountain has made it through for four, so the point differential remains the same as Satan's Little Helper is about to make another pass through.
Clock is on Angel City's side. All they have to do is trade points now until the period clock expires and then call it off.
And an additional 4 points to both teams right now. 220 to 190, 30 points separate these two teams. 57 seconds remaining on the clock, on the jam clock. Only 20 seconds remaining on the period clock. Soledad taking a seat. Oh, no, she's waved off. 4 more points added to Angel City. Hold, and she stops. And she's just kind of waiting it out.
There's
here, waiting it out.
7 seconds
to go.
Clock.
Wanting to make absolutely sure that there is not a horrible mistake made.
The last thing that they want right now is a penalty, although with only 30 seconds left in the jam.
So time has expired. She calls it off, and Angel City advances to the next round. Not only do they advance, but they also beat Rocky Mountain for the first time ever.
Angel City huddling in turn number four there. They are thrilled. You can see the celebrations. The unofficial final, 228 for Angel City, 198 for Rocky Mountain.
Yeah, I mean, this has got to be heartbreaking for Rocky Mountain to be four times in a row have gone to champs. Now this is the fifth time in a row they've gone to champs. They were, of course, the WFTDA champions in 2010. And being beaten here by a team that has never made it to championships before, it's just kind of, if Ohio is not the Cinderella story of the weekend, it entirely possible may be Angel City, who just came from out of, well, I don't want to say from out of nowhere, because they've been here for a very long time.
In particular, they caught a lot of attention at the beginning of the season, John Maddening, as they were performing extremely well. They were actually a number one seed going into their playoff tournament. They came out of that a number three seed for this tournament. But they now advance to play the Denver Roller Dolls, which is one of the number one seeds in the tournament. They'll play tomorrow afternoon at noon.
Noon Central Time.
Noon Central Time here in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, hosted by the Brew City Bruisers, the WFTDA Championship Tournament.
Angel City making their victory lap, big smiles on their faces. They are plumb happy to be there. Wow. What a fantastic game by both of these teams. Rocky Mountain again started those first four jams just holding down Angel City. Then Angel City made a break for it and just dominated the majority of the first half, coming at one point to a 50-point lead before Rocky Mountain was able to cut that down to only 10 points at the half. And then it was just trading leads back and forth and back and forth until about the last 10 minutes when Angel City really kind of got a solid lead and then just continued to just hold it and just hold it and hold it, not making any flashy plays, not making any craziness, just kind of holding it out, being very careful and not losing that lead.
What the key to winning the game really was the fact that Angel City got the last four lead calls in a row. That's what allowed them to hang on to that lead and build it up. Before that, Rocky Mountain was still had a slim but real lead. And so that's what really let them lock it down and take this victory.
And look at that penalty trouble that Rocky Mountain got themselves in. Bob Loblaw got that, her seventh trip to the box on that last jam of the game. Again, that's
Make
a throwaway.
Make You Pay also earned it seven penalties.
So, you know, if this game had gone an additional jam, they would have been sent back to the locker rooms. But, man, what a fantastic, fantastic game. Next up, we are going to have Ohio take on Rat City. That's going to take place at 6 o'clock Central Time here. But before that, we are going to go down to Randy Pan, our sideline reporter, who has, he's got Lacey Knight from Angel City. And over to you, Randy.
Hi there, Randy Pan, the Goat Boy here. I'm here with Lacey Knight after an incredible victory for Angel City. How you feeling?
I am ecstatic. There are no words to describe how it feels to have put all that hard work in and to make it come out on the track.
Now, you guys had went into the first seed at the playoffs, had a kind of a rough run. How did you adjust to come into championships?
We really just locked it down. We made it all about those tight hip walls, really digging in, making sure that is what brings our clean play back together.
Yeah, I wanted to ask you about that. Your clean play numbers had a big impact. Very few power jams, and overall your penalty minutes were very low. What kind of training did you do to set that up?
It was really, really just about digging in with that foot, hip-to-hip action, not being a little freaked out when offense is coming back at you, not feeling a little scattered if your wall gets broken up, but just really bringing it back to the wall over and over and over again.
That's smart. Positional blocking usually keeps you on the track.
Yeah.
Another stat that stood out is you guys got a very high lead jammer percentage. Is there any kind of training you did for that?
Really made it all about our jammers, just understanding that there has to be a little bit of patience, that it might not happen in 5 seconds right away, it might happen in 15, but they just have to trust that we're going to be okay in our wall, and they just got to push, and know that it's going to be all right.
You saw a lot of trust with your play out there, so very well done on that. Couple of big runs happened for Rocky Mountain in this. Definitely a big one in the first period where they had 50 points and two jams. Second period, you had your jammer in the five jams in a row with three penalties. How did you recover from that? How did you as a bench, did you prepare for that, or was it just all head game training the whole way?
I think a lot of teams understand that it comes all down to power jams, and so we spend a lot of time in practice working on power jams and just making it about, it's okay, that was a 20-second pass, let's just get another 20-second pass, and just really understanding that it's not about the numbers, but it's about being together. If we're together, we're going to win.
Wise words for y'all, for y'all out there. One last question. Denver, next. Coming in strong team, coming into the first seed. Anything we expect to see in that one without giving anything away?
Well, I think Denver is a completely different team from Rocky Mountain, and we just have to not let that really shake us. We have to play our game and just understand that it's about that calm, clean play. They're a very, like, hitty together team, and we have to just not kind of get sucked up into their play.
Copy. Well, the calm, clean play was very successful for you today. Congratulations, and thank you for talking to us here. We'll see you tomorrow, and we're going to check in with our sponsors out there on WFTDA.tv.
Hey, this is Dan from S1 Helmets. We're here at the Angel City Derby Girls practice facility, hanging out and watching them practice. A few years back, we noticed that a lot of girls playing roller derby were not wearing certified helmets. They were wearing non-certified soft foam helmets, and we were concerned. We've been trying to get the word out to everyone that plays roller derby to wear a helmet that is certified for multiple and single impacts. While we were here, Octane Jane was jamming, and she got hit, snapped her head back, and hit her head pretty hard. Octane Jane was fine. That's why we want girls in certified helmets, dual certified helmets, because you can't control how you fall in roller derby. It's a contact sport. You're going to get hit and you're going to go down. And this happens all the time, all around the world. And if you're in the wrong helmet, you're really going to hurt yourself. And she was wearing a Lifer helmet, which is dual certified, and she got up and she's fine. So we're stoked, and the helmet worked, and that's what this is all about.
I'm Kim Block, and we're here today with 30 of the best skaters in the UK to check out the new Atom 2014 wheel range. What have we got, Steph? We got the new G-Rods,
yep.
The low boys.
I'm very excited.
Yeah. Oh, you got the low boys.
Yeah.
The new strokers and the new DNA wheels. Everyone's really excited to be here, and we'll just see how they're finding it.
I've been skating on G-Rods, and they've been a massive upgrade from what I had before. They're just slippy enough to make me do cool stuff, and I love
them. They make you awesome.
They make me awesome!
Super G's, they're really responsive. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I use the DNAs, and they're super grippy, but I can still slide them, so it's really good, and really smooth. So it's been awesome.